الحمد لله الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده على من لا نبي بعده ولا أمة بعد أمته ولا كتاب بعد كتابه ولا شريعة بعد شريعته أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تدخلوا بيوتا غير بيوتكم حتى تستأنسوا وتسلموا على أهلها ذلكم خير لكم لعلكم تذكرون صدق الله العظيم. Respected viewers, welcome back once again to our program Rays of Light, where we throw light on various aspects of the Quran and see what Allah Ta'ala is telling us. And what is amazing about the Holy Quran? Yes, the Quran tells us about aqidah and belief, speaks about the aspect of Trinity, speaks about the aspect of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's greatness, speaks about our belief in Risalat prophethood, speaks about the Quran, and speaks about embryology, zoology, and the Qudrat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We did a whole program only on the aspect of the honeybee. But there are sometimes ayats of the Holy Quran and verses and commands which deals with day-to-day practices of morality interaction that sometimes you and I might regard as insignificant. We might regard it as, perhaps this is not important, but yet the fact that it is in the Quran tells us that it is important. And look at today, I'm just going to spend on those aspects which are absolutely astounding. Now look at this ayat which I have recited. Allah has shown us how to enter and to seek permission before entering another person's home. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O believers, la tadkhulu buyutan ghayra buyutikum. Do not enter into anyone's home other than your own home. That also in your own home, in the 18th supara of the Holy Quran, Allah Ta'ala has told children that there are three times after Isha, at the time when people normally rest, what we will call Qailula time, and after Fajr, don't enter your parents' room without permission. Now this Allah says ghayra buyut, besides your own home, then how do you enter into another person's home? Hatta tasta'nisu wa tusallimu ala ahliha, until you make salam upon the inhabitants of that home and seek permission to enter. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he used to enter into another person's home, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say, assalamu alaikum, if I would like to enter, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam also disliked this aspect, that when someone asks you, when you're knocking at someone's door, and Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to dislike this, that you're knocking at someone, someone said, who is it? And you said, me. So Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one day someone said, me. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, who's me? Relate your words, relate your identity. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to normally advocate this. Assalamu alaikum, it is Muhammad who would like to enter. Subhanallah. La tadkhulu buyutakum ghayra hatta tasta'an, until you take permission and you make salam. Fa illam tajidu, and if you do not get permission, do not enter into that. Wa in qila lakum urji'u farji'u huwa azka lakum. Subhanallah, what an amazing thing. You want to go and meet someone. Now he is not in a position to meet with you. He is maybe indisposed, he is sick. Maybe he is busy with his wife and children and he is not in a position to see you. Maybe he is about to go out somewhere and he tells you, I cannot see you now. Allah Ta'ala says, irji'u, return from there. Don't insist on entering and meeting him. It is better for you. It is pure for you. How many times you and I, we do not practice upon it? Allah has given us such details. If you go and ask permission for someone, I want to enter, I want to come and visit you. You don't know his circumstances. He might be sick, indisposed, want to go somewhere. Maybe he's got a family occasion. He tells you, I can't. Don't get angry. Unfortunately, today we get angry. We said, look at him. I have to make an appointment with him. He can't even give me an appointment. Allah says, no, وَإِن قِيلَ لَكُمْ ارْجِعُوا فَرْجِعُوا أَزْكَى لَكُمْ. If he tells you to go back, it is better for you. This is such beautiful aspects. The beauty of the Quran that it relates those aspects. What you and I regard as minute and insignificant. Look at another aspect that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us. وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ. Do not repel evil with evil. If you are going to put thorns in the path of those who put thorns in your path, the whole world will become strewn and will become filled with thorns. So Allah Ta'ala says, itfa billati hi ahsan. Repel evil with goodness. Someone is bad to you, be good to him. Someone deliberately becomes nasty to you, you deliberately become good to him. And you will make him feel low. You will feel that he will feel guilty. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, itfa billati hi ahsan. Do not repel evil with evil, repel evil with goodness. فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ. But that person who has enmity and hostility with you by this particular method, he will become your bosom friend. He will become your bosom. If he is not becoming your friend, the Quran cannot be false. It means you have not been able to repel evil with goodness. Let us look at another aspect of the Quran, something that you and I, we take for granted. وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحَا. Do not walk on the earth with arrogance. You know, people, they come and they walk with a particular style. You know, Allah Ta'ala says, do not walk with in the earth with arrogance. Don't beat down upon the earth. إِنَّكَ لَن تَخْرِكَ الْأَرْضِ وَلَن تَبْلُغَ الْجِبَالَ طُولًا. 15 Supara of the Quran, Surah Bani Israel. You, by walking arrogantly on the earth, you will not reach the mountain tops. And you will not be able to split the earth. Allah has made the earth strong enough. But by you walking with arrogance, you won't be able to split the earth. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another place, look at this beautiful. وَقَسِدْ فِي مَشْيِكْ. Walk moderately. Don't walk too fast. Don't walk too slow. Right? And وَقْسِدْ فِي وَقْذُدْ مِنْ سَوْتِكْ. Don't speak too loud and shout. إِنَّ عَنْكَرَ الْأَصْوَاتِ لَصَوْتُ الْحَمِيرِ. If shouting would have been a virtue, one of the loudest voices that you can get is the bray of the ass and the donkey, and that is no virtue. It's amazing, absolutely astounding that our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us aspect. Let me conclude with one more. In Surah Bani Israel, وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. Do not venture to give an opinion of that which you have no knowledge of. وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. And amazing, in this rays of light today, we have looked upon things that are so important, yet sometimes we regard as insignificant. Remember, if you look after the small aspects, you will be able to look after the bigger aspects. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا عَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.